therefore, he said, as for you also, because of the blood of your covenant, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless streets. Return to the stronghold, you prisoners of hope. Even today I declare that I will restore double to you. Someone say amen. In Romans chapter 4, verse 17 to 19, it says, as it is written, I have made you a father of many nations, in the presence of whom he believed. God who gives life to the dead and calls those things which do not exist as though they did. Who, contrary to hope, in hope believed. So that he became father of many nations, according to what was spoken, so shall he excellence be. And not being weak in faith, he did not consider his own body already dead, since he was about 100 years old, and the deadness of sinners. Today I want to talk about capture by hope. Have you been captured by hope? He said, you know, when I read Zechariah 9:12, it said prisoners of hope. You know, prisoner does not make, it's not a good word. But have I been captured by hope? Is everything from my head, everything, my thinking, my thoughts, even my prayer, sometimes when you pray, when I see some prayer points, I laugh. You know why? Because you are trying to get victory that you have already done. You have been glorified. You are already positionally victorious. How you pray will determine whether you actually believe, whether you are glorified, whether you are seated with Christ Jesus in the heavenly places. Sometimes we pray because we think we are surviving. No. I'm not saying. There are some times you make declaration, and that's why you are here. You make declaration. There are some times you worship God because of your connection. You need your connection with Him. But you see, I'm not devil focused. I don't go before looking for Him. I don't even ascribe to Him what happens to me so that I will feel good. Because sometimes you are not careful. When things happen to you, you even think it's God that did it to you so that you feel good about it. But I'm not devil focused. Why? Because the Bible says all authority has been given to me. Oh, that means that some people don't have. It's not that they have some power. The power you give to the enemy is the lie that says to you that you believe. And when you believe the lie, you have empowered the liar in your house. And there's no need that you will. Once you believe the lie, the liar is empowered in your life, then he becomes your God and your master. Because I believe, for me, if you ask me, I believe that the devil is overworked. 7.17 billion people is overworked. There were only 2 people before. He's overworked. And since he doesn't give birth, he doesn't create. So the same number of angels are there. And God may have created more angels, don't you think so? So they are for you. So you must understand that we can choose the context from which we live, and hope can be that context. What is the context with which you live? Do you live from the context of hope? Are you a prisoner of hope? Have you been captured by hope? You can live based on your circumstance, based on Nigeria's circumstance, based on that. But what God is calling us to do is that we should live from the context of hope. We can live in bondage to our circumstances or can live as prisoners of hope. Many of us are in bondage to circumstances. Circumstances of what people did, the decision they made. But I can tell you the truth. Jesus came to this world. That's why I tell people, Jesus for this perfect theology. I like to study Him. What will He do when they have people to pay tax? What will He do when they have people to feed and there was no money? Imagine Jesus crying to people and saying, oh, the ministry is closed.
the convenient, the comfortable, the predictable, challenge my complacency, influence my perspective, disrupt my plans. Plug into your calling, learn to lead in your sphere of influence, and join a mission thousands of years in the making. Leaders, influencers, visionaries, everyone, let's get ready to unite. In the name of Jesus, we've got a world to transform. We've got history to write.
To see a greater place than we do. That's why I don't pray the prayer, Lord, make me 10 times better. Because the greatest prophet I did was John the Baptist. And the Bible says John the Baptist is this in the kingdom. That means that John the Baptist is greater than Daniel. Who prayed 10 times better? And Jesus took his father and said, greater things you will do than I did. So how many times do you think I should be praying? Because if you don't change covenant, and begin to operate in the new covenant that God gave you, you start living as if you are living in the old covenant, and the people that even operated in the superior reality that even goes in the new covenant. How can they be getting a superior reality than me when you have an inferior covenant? And so you must understand this, that hope is holding our perspective eternal. That's the definition. Hope is holding our perspective eternal. That means that, what do I do? I look at eternity. And you know what? When I get grasp of eternity, then I will now begin to walk down to this side. So we will have more hope if we are convinced of eternity. And you know what? If you are not convinced of eternity, you will have more hope. The last mass, we will die and go to heaven. It's not enough. As the final analysis. So my perspective must not be earthly. My perspective must not be internal. My perspective must not be external. My perspective must be eternal. In other words, I have to look at the way God looks at things. I have to look at the things that God does. And to live without God is to deny eternity with God. So when I'm not living with hope, I'm denying eternity with God. That God does not exist. And so that's what I'm talking about. Being captivated, being captured, being prison of hope. One time I went to speak in a place where they're giving a hope. And they told me to come and speak on my ministry. After I finished speaking, somebody came to tell me, so you give me hope. I said, what do you think I should give you? In my mind, I can't preach and give you hopelessness. More than ever before, we need prophets of hope in Nigeria. Prophets of hope. Prophets of hope. Today we have voices of hopelessness. So what is our hope? Our hope is based on this resurrection. If the strength that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, life in our mother, then we can revive it. That means that anywhere I go, I'm supposed to revive things, not to speak death. So my life is not because I came to church and I pastor preached a good message that didn't go me. No, my hope is the fact that Jesus was elected. That could not hold him back. That's why death could not hold him back. Then what can hold me back? Because in his death, I was dying to back. In his resurrection, I resurrected. So everything that was done to Jesus on that cross, I was going through it. Just imagine you in your resurrected body. So you must understand that the enemy has succeeded in raising voices that represent hopelessness. It has succeeded. You go to social media, it's the voice of hopelessness. Nigeria will finish. They will give you statistics. Statistics of the church that what happened to the church in Turkey. Everything has happened in Nigeria. Everyone is. It's a voice of hopelessness. Turkey and Nigeria are two different things. And nobody asked. We are just prophets of hope in that time. We are just people that peace hope before the church. Or that everybody began to partner with the voice of hopelessness. And when you partner with the voice of hopelessness, then you create a hopeless situation. But when there is somebody partnering with the voice of hope, speaking hope, and declaring hope, that circumstance will begin to shift. That's why when you see we're talking about shifting the atmosphere in single place, not about there's no we are trying to build concern. No. There's an atmosphere that needs to be shifted. That means that when I come to a place, I'm an atmosphere shifter. So when I get to a place at home, there is hopelessness, I declare hope. It doesn't matter whether the thing is working well or not. For we look at the things that are seen are supposed to be created by the things that are unseen. And I'm supposed to be leading from the unseen reality. The unseen is, listen, to God, there's no natural and supernatural. Everything to him is natural. And that's that's supposed to be my reality. So, now today, it is politically correct to be hopeless. You say, my brother, you don't know the times. So, if you are speaking hope, they say this guy, you are just spiritually happy. So, when you speak hopelessness, you are correct. So, my brother, can you not tell the indices in Nigeria? Can you not tell the indices in the world? And most likely, you do not know that some indices in the world that more diseases have been reduced. Now than ever before. That there have been more 100 years ago there were more wars now than now. But nobody will tell you, they will tell you, it will burn. I remember when North Korea was checking, they said the third world war is coming. They prophesied that war is about to come together until Brexit came. Prophecy has come. 2000, the million bomb was so high that people said everybody stop buying this thing, the world will turn upside down. The year 2000, as of January, this will come, computer men will go crazy. They even wrote it at prophecy in their website, and they do not have to be deleted in it. I continue to see there's nothing that happened. It's a after the world has opened. I just imagine the first coming to a woman that is going to put her faith. Let me just finish. I'm not sure unbelievers will like him. He was quite afraid of sinners, but Pastor Jacobs. Pastor Jacobs was a special sinner. Step to social type of sinner that you don't do with any other sin. But he was their friend. It was politically correct for him to be pastor because I said, he's coming. politically correct, the people will be ready to say the prophet. He knows his mind. But you see, it takes the eye of hope, the eyes of hope, to see treasure in death. Our perspective will determine our completions. And our completion will determine our lives. The way we see will determine what you complete about your mission. And your completions will attack you. If you conclude that Nigeria will be, I tell you what you have said to me in the 60. When you conclude that he is finished, your completion will make you trust me to come in and sit down together. It's your completion. Would you come in and leave your house? Your completion about that, when you see somebody with something, you need to pray. That's why you pray. It's your perspective that made you to come into that conclusion. And your conclusion that made you to actually pray. When I see believers not actually doing what scripture says, I tell them that just know that their perspective has not changed. And because your perspective and take their completion span will not change. And how they live their life will not change. When you say you believe in something and not practice it, you don't actually believe in it. Because your belief will motivate your belief.
The predictable. Challenge my complacency. Influence my perspective. Disrupt my plans. Plug into your calling. Learn to lead in your sphere of influence. And join a mission thousands of years in the making. Leaders, influencers, visionaries, everyone, let's get ready to unite. In the name of Jesus, we've got a world to transform. We've got history to write.
You must understand that what keeps us in grace is our marriage to hopelessness. When we are fully married to hopelessness, it cannot be breached. And today, more than ever before, I believe the church in Nigeria should be giving up. So I see believers broadcasting some things of this hopeless. Say, Pastor, is it truth? No. Is it fact or the truth? Facts are subject to change. You know, what God says is that I see a company coming from another country, taking out a share and making plans and going for it. They're taking money from the bank and all of us take money. We didn't get it. The money you are buying, it's in the bank. You are not going to shout to my boy, stop shouting at them, say who? Say it loud and clear. Say it loud and clear. Refuse to have an area in your life with good God hostage. Refuse to have an area in your life that you are holding God hostage. I know there are some things in one area of your life that is not working. Refuse, because if you hold God hostage in that area, it's going to affect other areas of your life. Oh, God did not do this for me then. Oh, God did not do this for me then. Oh, God did not do this for me then. What is happening? I'm not going to judge. The many of us only good what God is saying because we are praying to our Lord. Something like we pray for our Lord. I'm talking about a trust that we give God for a retreat center for 25 years. When the company finally bought the retreat center, they gave them for this and told them to pay $1 every month. So one of the pastors was just angry and gave them $10. And after 1 year, they gave the church the retreat center for free. After paying $10. Can you stay hopeful for 25 years? Because God gave you. When you are staying hopeful and you have trained your child for 10 years, 20 years, you were hopeful, you didn't believe, you didn't look in back this time, you know. Many people remember. You had hope that this child will grow. So you have been operating in hope for a long time, only that you have not extended it to other areas of your life. So that you can be fully a prisoner of hope. May that become your reality. I pray that all of us here as a movement, as a family, will become prisoners of God. That when people see you, what you will be dispensing is hope. God will pass for prisoners of God. I believe that you will come to a season in heaven. The church should be a key of hope. It should be a place where hope will be amazing. And you don't need to come to church and go back to the process. You don't need to be happy with the process. Jesus came to a hopeless situation. He died on the context of hopelessness to determine his path to go back. He came to a time where his people were colonized. They were under the bondage of Rome. And he operated fully as a prophet of hope. He comes to a place where the barriers are even not stopped in life. He comes to a way the way the world has gone out, and they are fully drunk now, and he made one for them. Anywhere you go, Sunday school you are singing, he wants to be in there. So why would Nigeria rich people see us as an enemy? Because we have packed our own skin with forces and places. We must understand firstly that hope is faith. But I hope faith. Most times, I see people say, I have faith, I have faith. And when they think that it's not work, it gets tell you something about that. I hope it's not. I hope it will not be.
To order for copies of this message or other series by Benanke Akigbede II, please visit the Firm Exchange at number 5 Oregbeni Street of Idenya Road of Ihama Road, GRA, Benin City. You could also contact us via our telephone numbers 080-510-28787, 070-696-96499. You could send us an email on info@femfoundationng.org. Or you could visit our website on www.femfoundationng.org. Thanks and God bless.